this is sort of what we did for the training. We started off the first day with administrators. Like we said, it was a top-down approach to train the senior staff first, also to get sort of buy-in from them in terms of the application. Some of them were skeptical as the training started. And it was still it's a pilot application, so we ran into a few bugs during the training. Then the next day, we actually the senior staff training was in English and French, combination of that. And the following day was tougher because it was exclusively in Haitian Creole, but it was led by some of the senior staff that were trained the previous day to the nurses. And when we're training the auxiliary nurses, you get that thing that you don't want to see pop up on your screen, on the projector, live. App feed from the phone. Sorry, your application is unexpectedly closed. it's not the thing you want to see on the screen, but it turned out that the person who was typing it in had typed in an extra long name. We hadn't quite tested for that. We had test cases, but our test cases were not that long. And we did fix it, and the fix it only took us a few minutes to fix, but you could probably hear like an audible gasp in the room going, ooh. But we recovered, we had it working. So I think one of the things we had during the testing was we had another phone that we temporarily set up as a receiver. So every time someone made an update or did a registration, you could send it to this phone and you'd hear it beep. So you'd get an audible response that you're actually doing something. Sending it back. So just a recap was the in terms of future development, we are working on automating the form generation, those forms, so that you can customize it for different groups and collect different sets of data. We're trying to generalize the plugin architecture that we're building so that you can build it out for other applications beyond just the food distribution program. Building out our own standalone database that, so we right now we're interfacing with their existing database. We're trying to build another dedicated database that will go with the app to make this sort of standalone. And if the pilot goes successfully, they're planning to roll this application out with potential use in other countries that we could use this. Because it has the internationalization capability built into it. Just a quick pick of the team that went down to Haiti. All the students, project supervisors, and our Haitian contacts, the chief of body, Emmett. Jerry was the chief agronomist, and Eldeweg was the MIS manager. So if you're building an app like this for an organization or outside time, you want to make sure that you have someone who's a local champion. You don't want off the technology and the solution, you want to push it out. You don't want to just go in and have it just be something that, say, the CEO is pushing down on everyone else. You want some buy-in from the technical guys who would actually be the ones managing it. Because this human factor goes back to that, where you want people in the field to like it. During the distribution event, we had the auxiliary nurses using the mobile app while they were doing this existing data system, registering people. And initially, they were a little slower. They were slow on the app. They were taking turns to put in entries. Towards the middle, around like once we processed like 50 people, the nurses actually were typing in one, and they'd not give their seat up. They want to do another registration on the phone. And then towards the end, they were faster than the guy doing it on the paper. And they had it typed in quickly, and they were waiting for him to finish up so they could get the next person. So they seemed to be adapting well to the application. And I want to see how that rollout goes with it. So I thought I'd also end this on a slightly lighter note. Who knows the reference? You get it? That's good. So while we were in Haiti, we had a chance to observe. We were invited to attend a voodoo ceremony that was taking place right outside our hotel. It was, so we had an opportunity to go there, and one of the gentlemen in our group had his video camera. It's not the greatest video, but I thought I'll share it here just as a fun little thing for you guys to see firsthand from the voodoo ceremony. This was going on like till 3-4 in the morning, so it was hard to get some sleep too. They were incessantly drumming. So, this is not a light, you know, just play this clip. It's not a very good video, but you can just hear the background, the music. It gets better, it just clears up for a second. No, unfortunately the screen's not doing it justice. In the clip, actually, you get the mamba that's the main head priestess of the group. They were dancing, but yeah, it's clear on my screen, but I'm not.
Will it be in the YouTube somewhere? Is it Vimeo? Will it be in your website? Can you go and put it down?
The first video is up there. But
second video?
This one is just...
Okay, so...
Just a clip that we took. I thought I should share.
Tishan, I have two questions. Yeah. One is the reliability of your system. That is, what happens if there is failure somewhere? This is especially developing countries that happens. The second question is more for the advanced countries. People always only worry about security and privacy issue. How do they do the against anything special?
Well, the phones you can lock the authentication on the phones, and also the app itself has user IDs and lock passwords for different levels of users.
But when you do the SMS data, it is not encrypted, is it?
Not at this point. But it's compressed so much that if you don't know the actual mapping, it's not going to be useful for user. The worry would be that the phones, the couple hundred dollars phone potential worries for thieves. But it's a lot easier to hide a phone in your pocket than it is to carry around a laptop or a touchpad or a tablet PC. So that's another reason to go with that. The smartphones, over just using a basic cell phone, is that you can build out more features in it. You can have the information on there, tracking information. The app, like I said, to use distribution registration, but they also are using it so that what they call auxiliary agents that go out into the field, go out to farmers, they can take a device with them and look people up and check their records.
Thanks again, Sola. Tishan is a local RPI person, so he gets an RPI. This is again.